So we're live here at Show Studio, where we're embarking on a very exciting, very ambitious project with Iris van Herpen, who we're delighted to have with us. So thank you, Iris, for joining us.
Well, thank you for inviting me.
The project is also a collaboration with our very own Nick Knight and also Daphne Guinness. And it will see Iris's crystallization collection evolve into another new dress. And we will be broadcasting Iris creating this from start to finish over the next 7 days. So, of course, yesterday we were at Park Royal Studios, where we were joined by Daphne Guinness. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
We put a system up so that we had four cameras, so one at 12 o'clock, one at 3 o'clock, one at 6, one at 9, and so you get the front, sides and the back of what this dress will be. And then we used front cameras recording sort of 1,000 frames a second and then 2,000 frames a second. And just so we could see how this water travelled and how it collided. Every time we threw buckets of water at Daphne, I was terrified that she'd fall off. She has her Noritaka shoes, which are so high and they have no heel, and she's bouncing on that while two fully grown men are throwing water at her. So there's a certain amount of force hitting her.
Yeah.
But the weird thing is she's so kind of... I don't know if stoic's the right word.
Statuesque.
Yes, and she just kind of... sailed through it. Iris and I are now going to select, or hopefully select, the frame which we think represents the best dress. It's our process.
So the footage is going to be used in a number of ways. We're also joined by artists Jeffrey Lilliman and Salvador Breed, and we'll be using the footage to create a short film. Iris, do you want to tell us a little bit about the crystallization collection, first of all, and how you think that's going to evolve this week?
Crystallization for me was all about water. I've always been fascinated by water because I grew up next to it, and it would be really interesting to let something uncontrollable like that control my design process. This water dress is actually really not designed at all. It's the first time I'm gonna work like this, like trying to capture that moment and trying to make that dress that already actually exists.
Because you have the water here, and of course there's a certain amount of reality there, and a certain amount of things that you can't make. And how much are you willing to compromise?
I don't like compromising that much.
I didn't think you did, actually.
But it depends on the footage that we have. If I can find something that I can make, I'm gonna go into detail. I'm gonna try to make every drop. But if there is not something here that I can make, then I'm gonna make an interpretation of it. But I have the feeling we have captured the dress, so we just have to find it.
Is that the dress changed stylistically? So it became a cocktail dress, and then all of a sudden it was like a long evening dress. So the dress changed style, period, shape. As water travelled across it, it became different fashionable and different sort of fashion moments.
It's really a matter of 1/10 of a second that it already changes. That's quite amazing.
Right, so we found our dress.
Yeah.
That was a moment.
Thanks, kid.
Iris, I think that's incredibly exciting. It's a beautiful dress.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Really nice.
I hope in real life it will be the same.
Of course it will be.
And from here, will you make sketches and things like that, or will you just go from the raw images?
I think I just go from the images and go with the material. I think these are my sketches. So.
Great. So Iris, I'll let you get started. Thank you to everyone who's posted a question, and of course, you can post them throughout the day today and in the coming week. So good luck, Iris.
Thanks so much.
Thank you very much for coming back again. Iris, do you want to just tell us a little bit about yesterday and the day before?
And we picked the frame that we like as being the dress. I've been thinking about it, how to make it, and it's going to be quite difficult because this is a strapless dress, actually. So it has to lean on the waist, but how she's going to get in and out, I'm going to have to figure it out.
So today, what we're going to be going through is looking at all the footage, and it's going through and seeing the frames and the structure that almost gives the effect that the water starts changing into different materials because of the speed and because of how we do the color correction, because of the timing that we use. in a video, Salvador will be accompanied with sound design that's going to almost turn these things into a sound sculpture behavior.
And someone else has asked, how do you feel about revealing your craft? Would you be afraid of other people copying you? Or
it will be difficult to show all the processes. Yeah, some you just don't want to share, but it's nice to share. And copying will always be there. I'm not going to worry about that. No.
I mean, there's something nice about watching the process of anything being made. Mm. Because a lot of times we only see the end product on things. You know, like seeing an old masterful painting, for example. You can see where these magical creatures and designs, you know, come from. And it's quite beautiful.
I can really get inspired by technology like 3D printing or something more futuristic, but in the end, nature is one of the most fascinating things. We are still wearing fabrics, wools and silks and everything, but I really wonder if that's it's something we will still do in the future. Mm. It does trigger my imagination. Yeah. What else can you wear?
And how do you feel about the contrast of using a hard material to recreate something that's quite fluid?
Well, I have to use something hard to be able to create a still of something really organic. The nice thing of this material is that while it's warm, it's super fluid, so I can do everything with it. And then it stays in its form, so for me it's ideal to work with.
You can see it more. What's this point?
Yeah, I think this.
So, kind of like this.
Well, when I was small, I wasn't really involved in fashion. I grew up in a small village. Not really a fashion environment. I have a grandma who collects costumes and everything. She has a whole attic full of stuff. So that was, I think, the only connection to the world of fashion and clothes. So. But I didn't know if I wanted to do fashion. I had it in my head, but I wanted to do the pre-course to get a little bit of everything, like painting and sculpturing and fashion, and because I liked it all. Mm. And then after the pre-course, I decided to do fashion.
Do you have any advice for emerging designers?
Yeah, it is a big challenge to start your own company, and it is creatively but also financially, well, learning how to communicate with people, because in the end it's all about that, working with people. Mm. It's super nice to collaborate with people, but you not always know what will be the end result, which is the nice part about it. But yeah, you can see it as a failure, but I think it's part of collaborating as well.
So the dress is looking fantastic. You've taken it off the doll now and hung it up. Can you tell us a little bit about why you do that and what you're doing now?
The parts at the waist, where it will lean on the body, they were too close to the doll, so I couldn't get to there. But that's why I hang it up.
Yeah. And does it look how you imagined it would?
Yeah, I think so. Yeah, I had that picture, of course, to start with. But it was finding a balance between the beauty in real life and the beauty on the photo. Mm. If I would have copied it exactly, it would have been not nice in real life.
And Jeffrey, you were speaking with Nick and everyone a bit earlier. Can you tell us a little bit about that and where you're heading?
We're taking cues from sort of a Renaissance, finding ways to make those frames out of water, allowing a framework for the shots of Daphne to be inside of that. And we're finding that we're getting optic effects to make it look like almost like a full body length mirror that you would have in some kind of, I guess we've been coining around the word luxury LSD kind of environment, so.
And Salvador, do you want to tell us a little bit about how you'll react to the visuals?
Something I want to do now is work with the material of Daphne singing to also give that a bit more realism, because I found things a bit too abstract So I tried to add a bit more human element to it. That was also something that Nick proposed, and I think it's a good idea.
And so tomorrow we're going to be joined by Darren Horton, who is an air spray artist who will colour in the parts of the black that the dress that are black.
Yeah.
Will you just talk us through how you'll kind of determine where he should spray and not spray and all of that?
Well, I'm going to ask him to spray the font, but I think also what you can see now is that part from the back you see through the front, so it would be a shame to make it all black, like it is on the picture, because I think you just lose the depth and the movement of the material. Probably it will take the whole day to do it really nicely.
Yeah. And Iris, are you happy with the final result?
Yeah, I'm really happy. Yeah, it really fits to the whole project, and it makes it come closer to the photo again. Well, and then you see the black through the transparent, and it all comes together. Mm-hmm. So I'm really happy.
Yeah. So tomorrow is the climax of the whole project, at the end of our 7-day live broadcast. Thank you so much.
Yeah, thank you.